everyone. Today, I will show you how to operate our load bank with intelligent control and remote control. This load bank is 1250 kVA. It is a combination of resistive and inductive type load bank. The power factor is 0.8 and 1.0. Before to operate load banks, we have to do the wire connection and make sure all the equipment connect to our load banks well. First, we have to connect our tested generator to our load banks. Yeah, by bus bar, UVW, three phase. And also we have to connect the N phase. This one, it is N phase. N phase have two functions. One is supply the control power to our load bank. The other one is to make sure the testing data more precise. For control power, we have two options. One is from the tested power generator, and the other one is from the mains power. In our factory, it is better to use mains power as the control power because the mains power is more stable. Yeah, this socket is connect the to our mains power for control power. Yeah, this is the circuit breaker to protect our control power. First one, we turn on this circuit breaker and press it. It trips. It means this breaker is in good status. Then we choose the mains power as the control power. Genset means use the tested power generator as the control power. Yeah. Now, this one, this interface is RJ45. It is for remote control. Yeah. We use the internet cable to connect to our laptop. Yeah. Yeah. This laptop is for remote control to our load bank. Yeah. This cabinet is for installation of the generator tester. Yeah, this is our generator tester. Yeah. And this breaker, it is for protect the generator tester. And this socket is supplied the power to our tester. And this interface is for receiving the testing data from the load bank. Yeah, we have to connect it, yeah, to our tester. Now we turn on this tester. Yeah. This is our control panel. First one, we have to turn on the power source. The meters, the indicator will light up, means the control power had connected well. This is phase sequence indicator. We press these buttons. The rotation in clockwise means the phase sequence is right. If the rotation is opposite, the phase sequence is wrong. You have to check again. This is the multi-function meter. You will show the testing data later. This is the control mode. Remote control and local control. If we choose the local control, the remote control will not work. This touch screen is to control the local control. Enter. There are four pages. Manual control, auto control, setting, and alert. Four pages. First page, it is manual control. For manual control, first we make sure the exhaust cover is open. If the exhaust cover is open, it is green. Yeah, because our load bank is air intake from the bottom and heat dispatch to the top. We make a waterproof cover for this load bank, so we have to make sure the exhaust cover is open. Yeah, it is green, means it is open. Now we turn on the fans. The fan status indicator will light. Yeah. We can test the fans working in good station or not. We use a paper to put on these louvers. The paper cannot fall down, means the fans good working in good station. how we turn on the master load, increase the load 10 kilowatt. You can see the indicator light up 10 kilowatt. If we haven't started the fan, we do a test. We turn off the fan. We turn on the master load. We increase the load. Yeah, it will not work because we have protection for our heat. If we haven't opened the fan, the load will cannot increase. So we first turn on the fan. Fan status is working in good station. Yeah, master load. And now we start increase the load 110. If we need to 2 kilowatt, we can operate at here 1, 2. Yeah, we can use this functioning switch to choose the power from 0 to 10 kilowatt. You will find the power factor here. It is 1.0 because we only open the resistive load. If we need the low banks, test at 0.8, we need increase the inductive load. Here, next page, here. It is KVAR, yeah. If we at 100 at this place, we also press these buttons. 10 kilowatt at this place, we open, yeah. And finally, we will find that the after at the inductive load, the power factor will be 0.8. Yeah. Okay, we also can do the master load. It will sudden unloading and sudden load. It is very important to test the generator performance for sudden load and sudden unload. Second page, it is auto control. For auto control, it is very easy. First, we can enter the tested power. For example, 165. Yeah. Then we can set the tested load step, such as 10 kilowatt, 50 kilowatt, 100 kilowatt. It depends on you. But usually, we will choose the default setting. For default setting, we can press this button to confirm. The power factor will be 0%, 25%, 50%, 75%, 100%, and 10% overload. Yeah. And next, we can choose the power factor. Yeah. This one is 1.0. This one is 0.8. We choose 0.8. For the onload or offload duration, you can set the time, for example, 3 minutes. Yeah, but usually for test, we will make it shorter, 1 minute. Yeah. Now, after setting the data, so we press this star, it will be automatic control. Yeah. Yeah. Now it is automatic control. Automatic loading. The power factor is 0.8. the voltage is nearly 400, yeah, and the frequency tested power. The third page, it is setting. You can find that we cannot enter the setting page. For this page, we need enter the password. The password is 654321. Enter. Yeah. Now we enter the setting page. For this page, you can set in the data such as the auto mode, contact activity and deactivity interval, auto mode load deviation, auto mode data recording interval, pulling down the duration, load disable when the fan failure and overheating. Also, you can set the threshold duration for over voltage and overload. Yeah, you can set the data at this page. For the last page, it is alert. We have the overheating, over voltage, overload alert. Emergency stop, you can press at these buttons. This part, it is alert for the fan failure. Each fan have one number. The first one, second one, third one, and fourth one. Yeah. If the fans get problem, the corresponding buttons will alarm. Yeah.